Friends, I also think it's important to point out the Honorable Prime Minister had made a speech recently in Parliament and calling the 2004-2014 a lost decade. Unhone kaha ye ek dashak humne kho diya. I want to remind him and through you the country, 2004-14 was an era of unprecedented GDP growth. It was an era where 140 million people were lifted out of abject poverty, and we had robust growth in every sector. The economy was doing better than ever before. There was a reverse brain drain, unlike now, when high worth individuals, intellectuals, qualified people are leaving the country for various reasons. At that time, we had a reverse brain drain. We had economic growth, unprecedented growth before. And India, what it is today, a large part of it is actually the strength we have, the leverage we have, the geopolitical strength India has today, which the current government is taking benefit of. That was really that decade which put India on the global map in terms of our IT sector, our telecom sector, our liberalized economy, and all of our export initiatives that we took at that time. So 2004-14 was also a breakthrough record decade, because not only did we grow economically, liberalized policies, but we also had social sector programs that are paying us dividends today. Right to food security, right to education, right to employment, right to information, right for tribals. All those rights and fundamental issues were taken up by the UPA government, Dr. Manmohan Singh ji. And I think Dr. Manmohan Singh ji has said that history will judge me far more leniently than what is being said about me now. We had the Indian nuclear USD. The BJP actually was opposed to the US nuclear deal. They were opposed to direct benefit transfer. They were opposed to GST. They were opposed to FDI in retail. They were opposed to FDI in defense. And now they're doing exactly the same thing. Raat ke 12 baje GST chalu karte hain. DBT hum logon ne chalu kiya, wo uska credit lete hain. Hum logon ne broadband panchayat mein lekar gaye, wo uska credit lete hain. And for the last 8 years, what the BJP has done is given a slogan every 2 months. Stand up India, fit India, make it India, khelo India. Before one is able to take cognizance of what the new last slogan was, ek naya slogan aa jata hai. On the ground delivery is what it is. We have the highest unemployment in the last 5 decades in this country. Highest unemployment. Petrol prices, diesel prices, LPG prices have never seen this increase ever before. And the government is actually curtailing the power and the financial contribution of the state governments. Therefore, the BJP has a lot to answer. I think we are seeing elections in Tripura, Nagaland, Meghalaya, and very soon in Karnataka. So I'm of the opinion that the Congress party will do extremely well in these elections. But Karnataka, I just want to add, is a state where the people of Karnataka, this is not just the Congress party, people of Karnataka are looking for a government that works for them. They are looking for a government that does not do polarized politics. They're looking for a government that is their government, that wants to create jobs, that wants to create wealth. Look at the situation in Bangalore today, where we are today. What has happened to our city last few years? I mean, this is a government that really has a lot of debt to pay. People will seek that price, and I'm absolutely confident that as and when the Election Commission announces election to Karnataka, there is no doubt in my mind that not only will we form the government, we'll have a single largest majority ever that the Congress party has secured, and we'll have a government that is for the Karnataka people. And that's all I have to say. If you have any questions, I'm happy to answer.
Mr. Pilot, what do you want to say about the kind of the promises which Congress is planning to give for upcoming elections? When you talk about Adani, there are many billionaires throughout the world are condemning, and they are saying that it may push back India to economic crisis. How do you see this kind of?
I just feel that forget about the rest of the world. People of India are asking these questions, and it's not about an individual. It's about the system being misused. It's about the credibility of the institutions that are in question. It is a question what the SEBI is doing, what the RBI has not done, regulatory bodies that were made for this particular purpose were overlooked. There is certainly a systematic sequence of events which have led to this massive increase in such a short time for a person who was ranked 70th or 69th in the world to become number 2. It begs the question that fine, a lot of people do well, but was there compliance, was there connivance, was there wrongdoing on the part of the banks, the government of institutions, the PS and the government itself? There are many questions being raised. All we are saying is without doing a blame game, if the question has come up, the best way to resolve is to investigate. Let it be a thorough investigation, let it be a JPC, and the truth shall come out. It is not that the JPC has never been formed before. Pehle bahut baar JPC bana tha. But I don't want to go into what others are saying. I just want to speak for the people of India and what the Congress party is asking the government.
So the government has hit back at George Soros this morning also. Right now, Smriti Irani was doing a press conference that it's an attack on India, that undermining India's might and power, and we will hit back at them.
But I think India's might and power is not resting on the shoulders of one or two individuals. It rests on the 140 crore people of this country, the farmers of this country who have toiled hard, who have got us independence, our forefathers, and the tremendous amount of energy and potential that our people have today. So India's strength is its people and not 4, 5, 10, 20 individuals. So I don't really care what about anyone else is saying. I just want to limit myself to say that we as Indian citizens, we as political activists have the right to ask questions. In a democracy, it is the job, the duty, the obligation of the ruling party to come up with answers. All we are saying is that if you have nothing to hide, why don't you have a JPC and a time-bound investigation where the truth shall prevail? That is a simple request, which I think is not something that has happened not before. It can happen, but obviously there is something to hide. That is why the hesitance in accepting a JPC.
सर आपकी पार्टी जांच की मांग कर रही है. काउंटर क्लेम्स ये भी है कि राजस्थान में जो आपकी सरकार है उन्होंने भी बहुत कुछ अडानी को दिया, तो क्या आप इस पे भी सहमत?
इसके बारे में राहुल जी ने पहले ही बोला था, जब आप सवाल पहली बार उठा था, कि कोई कितना भी बड़ा व्यक्ति हो, अगर किसी कांग्रेस शासित प्रदेश के अंदर कोई निवेश हो रहा है तो पूरी तरह 100% पारदर्शी होना चाहिए, ट्रांसपेरेंट होना चाहिए. उसमें अगर 1% की गुंजाइश है ऊपर नीचे की, उसकी तुरंत जांच भी होनी चाहिए. और जब वो सब पैरामीटर्स को लीगली ट्रांसपेरेंट तरीके से पास करने के बाद अगर किसी को काम दिया जाता है वो तो ठीक है, लेकिन अगर वहां भी गई है, जब जांच होगी तो सारी की जांच होगी ना. इसमें जब जेपीसी की जांच होगी तो उसमें उत्तर प्रदेश है या मध्य प्रदेश है, राजस्थान है, उसमें क्या फर्क पड़ता है? वो तो फिर पूरी संस्था की जांच होगी और सच निकल कर आएगा उसमें.
In your state, you've been asking for a committee to look into question paper leak with your chief minister. There is no investigation in that, no committee announced. Isn't it a little paradox?
You're confusing the issue. A joint parliamentary committee is at the national level and it involves all parties. It's a set structure. There's nothing new. In various states where demands are made, that we can discuss later. But today the question is, why is the BJP government not agreeing to JPC? It's not my question. The country wants to know that if you have nothing to hide, तो आप क्यों नहीं करा रहे हैं? ऐसे तो उत्तर प्रदेश में बहुत इशू है, मध्य प्रदेश में है, दिल्ली में है, लेकिन ये जो इशू है ये अभी चर्चा में है, सुर्खियों में है, पूरी दुनिया में इसकी चर्चा हो रही है. और मैं समझता हूँ कि भारतवर्ष एक बहुत मजबूत अर्थव्यवस्था है, बहुत मजबूत देश है, लेकिन इस प्रकार के प्रकरण अगर आते हैं तो सवाल तो उठेंगे. उन सवालों को खत्म करने के लिए, हमेशा हमेशा के लिए समाप्त करने के लिए एक निष्पक्ष जांच बहुत जरूरी है. इतना हम लोग मांग कर रहे हैं और जांच करनी चाहिए. आज दबी जुबान में, मैं समझता हूँ बहुत मीडिया में प्रकाशित नहीं होता, लेकिन चर्चा है घरों में, लोगों के बरामदों में, जो चर्चा करते हैं कि इतने लाख करोड़ रुपए जो एकदम से गायब हो गए हैं, वो निवेश जो LIC है, स्टेट बैंक ऑफ इंडिया है, वो लोगों की गाड़ी कमाई, 26 करोड़ लोगों ने निवेश किया LIC के अंदर. अगर उनकी गाड़ी कमाई को कल आशंका होती है कि वो कहाँ जाएगा, तो चिंता करना स्वाभाविक है हम लोगों के लिए.
सर आपके राज्य में जो हुआ है, राजस्थान में दो लोगों को मारा गया है, हरियाणा में आपके MLA का बयान है कि FIR दर्ज होने में देर हुआ.
इस प्रकरण के बारे में मैं इतना ही कहना चाहता हूँ, जो मेरी सीमित जानकारी, क्योंकि मैं हवाई जहाज में था, ये हरियाणा पुलिस और राजस्थान पुलिस जॉइंटली इसको इन्वेस्टिगेट कर रहे हैं. शायद एक व्यक्ति को अरेस्ट भी किया गया है, लेकिन इस घिनौने क्राइम में जो भी इन्वॉल्व होगा इसकी निष्पक्ष जांच होगी, और जो भी आरोपी हो, कहीं का कोई भी हो, उस पर तुरंत कार्रवाई करने के काम हमारी सरकार करेगी.
सचिन जी, आप क्या कहेंगे जिस तरह के राजनीति राजस्थान में चल रही है, बहुत सारे आपके जो सपोर्टर्स पहले आवाज उठाए थे कि आपको CM के कैंडिडेट बनाया जाए, अब वो अभी भी फिर कह रहे हैं कि आप
राजस्थान के विषय में, मैं बात जयपुर में कर चुका हूँ, बेंगलुरु में इसके बारे में बात नहीं करना चाहता हूँ, लेकिन इतना ही कहना चाहता हूँ आप लोगों को,
मैं CM फेस बनना चाहिए.
प्रदेश के बारे में पार्टी को जो भी निर्णय लेना है वो अखिल भारतीय कांग्रेस कमेटी, हमारे कांग्रेस की लीडरशिप सही समय में सही निर्णय लेंगे, मुझे पूरा विश्वास है. लेकिन हम सबका सामूहिक उद्देश्य यही है कि हम लोग 2023 में मध्य प्रदेश, राजस्थान, छत्तीसगढ़ 3 राज्य हैं, तीनों में सरकार कांग्रेस पार्टी की बनाए, हम लोग रिपीट हम लोग करें. और मैंने अपने सुझाव पार्टी को दिए हैं, सही समय पे सही निर्णय लेंगे, ऐसा मुझे लगता है।
सर, पार्टी का लीडरशिप ये कहती है कि राजस्थान में सब कुछ ठीक है, लेकिन हम देखते हैं कि आपको तो कुर्सी भी नहीं।
हम सबका सामूहिक दह यही है कि हम ये परिपाटी जो 30 साल से आ रही है ना, कि 5 साल भाजपा 5 साल कांग्रेस, इस परिपाटी को तोड़ना है। इससे पहले भी कांग्रेस की गवर्नमेंट रिपीट हुई है, दिल्ली में 3 बार हुई है, असम में 3 बार हुई है, तो राजस्थान में हो सकती है। और हमको जो करना है नहीं करना वो पार्टी नेतृत्व तय करेगा।
राजस्थान राजस्थान दिल्ली में बात करें,
आप बीजेपी के साथी से पूछो कि आप अडानी जी बीजेपी से क्यों नहीं बना रहे हैं। पहली बात तो
सर, टुडेज बजट दे अनाउंस दैट बीजेपी गवर्नमेंट विल बिल्ड द लार्जेस्ट राम टेंपल इन सदर्न इंडिया।
This is last ditch effort. That means if they're making that, I've not heard that's the announcement they're making, that means they're losing the election for sure. Abhi 2 mahine pehle inko yaad aa rahi hai mandir masjid ki. That means they're not basing on development, on investments, on job creation, on economic growth. They want to again polarize, divide and divert the attention of people of Karnataka on issues that frankly at the eve of the elections make no sense. Why didn't not this government do this when they first took charge? Why they're resorting to these? Because they believe that they can't counter the Congress's campaign, the promises that we have made, the PCC has made, the AICC has made for women, amount of money we want to give every month to women in this household, in this state, and amount of electricity we want to give. So we are making commitments through our manifesto, which even the Chief Minister in his budget speech can't counter. You can well imagine, he has the power, the resources, and a double engine, as so they say. अभी double engine बोलते हैं लोग, एक engine हमने seize किया शिमला में, हिमाचल प्रदेश में। सेकेंड इंजन यहां सीज करेंगे बैंगलोर के अंदर। तो ये सब इंजन की बात सब फालतू है, होने वाला कुछ नहीं। सरकार कांग्रेस की बनेगी और पूरे बहुमत के साथ बनेगी। और मैं समझता हूं फ्रॉम व्हाट आई अंडरस्टैंड रिपोर्ट्स आई हैव गॉट फ्रॉम वेरियस पार्ट्स, अभी तक इतना बहुमत हम कभी नहीं मिला होगा, इतना बहुमत कांग्रेस पार्टी को मिलेगा इस बार।
वेल दैट